Well, thanks a lot, Bob. There's not much to complain about when you win series, and the Yankees keep winning series. They took 2 out of 3 in St. Pete, and they took 2 out of 3 in Baltimore. But when you lose the final game of a series where you could sweep, there's a little bit of a bitter aftertaste, Kenny.
That's very true, Michael, especially this afternoon when the Yankees jumped out to a lead in the first inning, a 4-0 lead, and it looked like they were on their way to a sweep. But Jordan Montgomery didn't have it this afternoon, and he let the Orioles back in, and eventually they scored enough runs off the Yankee bullpen to take the lead and win the game. And yes, like they say, 2 out of 3 is not bad, but when you lose that last one, it's got to be a little bittersweet.
Yeah, and they've done it twice now on this road trip, and now you go into a 4-game set against Texas. And, Kenny, it's hard to win 4-game series. Yeah. You got to take, obviously, 3 of the 4. Usually they get split, and then all of a sudden you're coming back home, and you're 6-4, and that has a little bit of a different feel to it.
Yeah, that's true, but they got their number one man going in the opening game. Gerrit Cole will be pitching for the Yankees tomorrow night down in Texas. I'm anxious to see the new stadium down there and just see what he does following up that great outing that he had down at Tampa Bay against the Rays. Now, Gerrit Cole is the type of pitcher, when you sign a pitcher like that, he's the one who keeps winning streaks going and keeps you from having losing streaks. So the Yankees lose the last one. They turn to Gerrit Cole. Maybe they can go in the other direction.
All right, let's pick up some of the big, important things that happened over these last two series. And the most important thing, and we said this in the open, Kenny, Aaron Judge is back to being Aaron Judge after that 7-game stretch where I believe he was 2 for 24.
Yeah, 4 home runs in this series. I know that he hits well here in Baltimore, and so do the rest of the Yankees, but he's been spectacular. It all started down in Tropicana Field. He had a home run against the Rays and helped the Yankees win a ball game. And now he continues this. And going into Texas, I'm anxious to see what he does and the rest of the Yankee offense does down in Texas against the Rangers.
And another guy that you have to look at and look at in a positive way is Gary Sanchez. Yankee fans like to pile on Sanchez, and he certainly got off to a shaky start. But all of a sudden, he's producing every single game, and the home run has come back into his arsenal.
Yeah, he had a long one today. And I think one thing, he's not chasing as many bad pitches, and he's having better swings at the pitches in the strike zone. Looks like he's not trying to do too much, and it looks like he's trying to get more catching behind home plate.
And finally, Clint Frazier had a home run today and another hit as well. Kenny made a nice diving play out in right field. They need Clint Frazier not to be a 141 hitter. They need Clint Frazier to be hitting in the mid-200s with about 28 home runs.
That's true. And, you know, you park him down at the bottom of the order, but you want production from down there. And if he continues to swing the bat like he did today, he, too, will be going in the right direction.
And the Yankees' direction they'll be going in, south. They'll be headed to Texas. And I know you love the song. They're going deep to the heart of Texas, Kenny.
Yeah, that's true. And, you know, now they don't have to worry about the Texas heat, though. I mean, they've got an air-conditioned ballpark with a roof. I heard the other day it was near 100 degrees down in Dallas already. We're only in May. You can only imagine what it's going to be like in July and August down there.
It should be a fun series. And the Yankees obviously will try to take a 3 out of 4 and make this an outstanding road trip, Bob.